What is up, Karatics? Welcome back to the series where I customize and review past DLC and OG vehicles that I never got a chance to because I didn't start making car customization videos till about late 2015. Again, guys, let me know in the comments what car from late 2015 and older you want me to customize next, and I'll display the most liked vehicle suggestion comment in the next customization video. So, in today's video, we're going to be customizing the Coil Brawler. So this car came out with the Ill-Gotten Gains Part 2 update in July of 2015. And I remember back then, before this car came out, Rockstar teased a photo of it. Everyone saw that Coil badge on the side, and they immediately assumed that it was going to be an electric off-road car. But when it finally released, it of course was a normal internal combustion engine car. So kind of funny how Rockstar kind of threw it out there. And to this day, this is the only Coil branded car that has a normal engine and is not electric. Now, this car can be found on the Legendary Motorsport website for about $700,000, which is pretty expensive for an off-roader. But if you really think about it, considering how almost every car Rockstar adds in these days is over $1 million, the $700,000 isn't really too bad of a price. Now, in terms of performance, the Brawler is actually the second highest vehicle in the off-roads class in terms of top speed, which is very impressive. Its acceleration and handling are pretty good as well. However, it's still around 10th place for most off-road tracks. So you might be wondering why, if it has the acceleration, it has the top speed, why is it only around 10th place for most tracks? Well, the brakes on this thing are extremely, extremely poor. If you've ever driven the Rat Truck, for example, they're kind of similar to that. It's a very unpleasant driving experience when you brake and it keeps going, like if you're driving on snow. It's just not that great. And there are some techniques to brake a little less than going full brake, and it does help slightly, but the brakes at the end of the day are still very poor. Now, this car is technically all-wheel drive. However, only like 10% of the power actually goes to the front wheels. The 90 plus still goes to the rear wheels. So it basically drives like a rear-wheel drive car, and the front wheels barely do anything at all. But it still sort of makes sense, as the car that it's actually based on in real life is rear-wheel drive. And speaking of that, the Coil Brawler is primarily based on the Local Motors Rally Fighter. You might recognize it from the Fate of the Furious movie as the car Letty drove. It's a pretty cool vehicle, but you just have to remember that its overall performance isn't that great. However, it still has some positives to it. But anyways, let's go ahead and check out the customization of the Brawler.
What are we doing today?
All right, Brawler. All right, we got armor, brakes, which the brakes barely work, but that's that there. Bumpers, bull bar and lights, and bull bar with winch and lights. Okay, different look there. Now, to note, these lights don't actually work. These upgradable lights, so just keep that in mind. You're mostly buying one of these for looks, which the second one doesn't look too bad, makes it look a bit more aggressive. The last one just looks kind of strange to me. It's kind of flat. So I guess we'll do this one. Rear bumpers, you have the bumper bar, and then you have the bumper bar and spare tire. Okay. Now, the spare tire on this one, you know, this option, if you change the wheels, then it doesn't really match. You know, you have different wheels than what your spare tire is, so it looks a bit strange. Also to note, if you look at the stock wheels here, they have the little bolts, and then the spare tire doesn't have that, so that's kind of funny. So I think we'll do the bumper bar. It doesn't look too bad. It kind of match our front. Okay, chassis, you have the roll cage. So the roll cage is pretty cool. Other than adding the obvious roll cage, it also adds some really cool looking red sports seats, which I think are nice. See, in first person, pretty nice there. It gives it a nicer touch, makes it look a bit more premium inside, so we'll do that. Engine. Okay, lights. I think we'll leave the stock kind of whitish lights there. License plate. So I already got my rally plate on here. We'll just give it a black background. So color. So for this, we're gonna do a matte black, which makes it look really, really aggressive, and then we're gonna go to a glossy Torino red, which is really gonna brighten it up, look a bit good, match our interior as well. Secondary, there we go. So I think we might do the regular red. No, the Torino red. It's a bit brighter. Oh, matches our roll cage too. Look at that. It says linked to our roll cage. That's pretty sick. All right, we'll do the red there. I think the formula red looks the best. See the regular. It's a bit of a tough one there. Torino red is a bit bright. I think it's a little bit too bright for it. We'll do the regular red. Your cribulum goes on the side of the door, both sides. Roof, you got spotlights that don't work as well. So keep that in mind. Spotlights with rack. And then you have the spare wheel. And then the, well, all the other stuff. You can have two spare tires on this. One on the back, one on the roof. Kind of funny. I really wish they had the rack without the spotlights. I think that would have been a nice option. On like a smooth rack with, you know, without the light bar stuff for spotlights. But, I don't know. It looks kind of weird on the roof of this thing. I think I'm not going to do that. Suspension. Here you can lower it if you want. I wish you can lift it a bit more, but unfortunately Rockstar doesn't let you lift off-road vehicles. But yeah, if you want to make it look more like a car, you can lower it all the way, put normal wheels on it, and boom, you have something that looks kind of like a normal car if you want to do that to this vehicle. But I like the off-road look, so we're going to keep that. It's what it's meant to be. Race transmission, turbo, wheels. So I actually really like the stock wheels on this thing, but it does have the old tread pattern. I do want to put the newer tread pattern from the off-road wheel category on it. Plus, I want to change up the look of the wheels a little bit. So we're going to go here to these wheels here. So you have all the newer off-road wheels here. Really nice ones. I think this one looks pretty good as well. But I think the Rallymasters suited pretty well, the concave Rallymasters. And they still got that kind of beadlock look on them, especially when we paint them black. Oh wow, that looks really, really good. That is nice. So we'll do that. And then windows, we black them out. Yeah, it looks pretty sick blacked out. We'll do that. And that's all the options there. All right, let's exit to ground, take it for a drive. Those wheels look really good on there. That black and red color combo going on as well. All right, rev it. Definitely not an electric car. The only coil vehicle that is not electric. Sounds pretty good. Got the Sultan interior. Not too bad. These things in real life have LS motors, so pretty good exhaust note. Alright, it's floored here. Wow. Gets up and goes very quick. So, I mean, it is a quick vehicle. It's not slow. It has pretty good acceleration, pretty good top speed, pretty decent handling. It just really, really lacks in the braking department. So I'm going to brake right about now. Braking, 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 still braking, still braking, still braking. Now we're at a stop. Just takes forever. And there are techniques to where you don't brake all the way. You just brake like a little more than halfway. And it does help slightly, but it's still bad. At the end of the day, no matter what technique you use, the brakes are still awful. Even if you do a little bit of brake all the way, whatever, it's still pretty bad. So that's like the technique there. So it stops a bit better, but it's still not great. So that's the unfortunate part of this vehicle, what really hurts it the most. So I mean, you try to come up to a corner and brake to take it, and you have to brake so far in advance that it just, you lose so much on lap time. You really do, or on tracks. And because having to brake that much earlier, it really, really impacts your lap time and your performance. Off-roading as well, you need good brakes. When you're going up and down mountains, you need decent brakes. And this thing, of course, you brake and just keeps going right down the mountain. Really can't do much. So when you're off-roading, make sure you're going in a straight line and you're not going, well, not planning to stop anytime soon. You're just going really fast over certain obstacles. But overall, still a great vehicle. It's a ton of fun to drive. You just got to deal with those brakes that are a bit annoying. But if you kind of try to brake not all the way, and it does help a bit, but it's still there. All right, let's pull over here so we can open all the doors and stuff. Pull over right here. Hello. All right. This thing looks really good at night as well. Vehicle doors, see all. Nice. And you got the hood that opens the other way. I love that. The engine model there. It looks like a Sultan engine model. Kind of strange. I mean, these things in real life have an LS motor, so that definitely does not fit this one. But Not too bad. Alright, alright. Oh, I accidentally closed the door. Got the trunk, the interior. Looks like we got a manual in there. Not bad. Overall, great vehicle. Is it worth $700,000? I don't know. I'd say it's worth more along the lines of like $400,000 to $500,000 at the most, because you still gotta, you know, put some money and upgrades in it. I'd say if you can snag it on sale, it's a good deal. But at its normal price, it's a bit of a stretch. $700,000 these days is pretty decently priced. You know, the most stuff they add these days in the game is over $1 million. I mean, I'm sure if they added this now, it would probably be, what, 1.5 million? Something ridiculous like that. But it's $700,000 now. You know, it's an older vehicle, of course, from 2015. And if you buy it on sale, I think it's a really good buy. Of course, you just have to remember the brakes and brake very early. Just act like you're driving in the rain or the snow and you'll be fine. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed. Remember to let me know down below in the comments what car from late 2015 and older you want me to customize next. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.